Exploring Jedediah Smith Redwoods State Park. This is a John's Travel Adventures production. This park was established in 1929. It has predominantly old-growth redwoods. It is bisected by the last major free-flowing river in California, the Smith River. Later on, there's some footage of the South Fork of the river outside the park. The park has 87 family campsites and a large day-use area. We headed north on Highway 101 from Humboldt County. First, you see the big bears as we cross the Klamath River. Before 1964, there was a little town up here that all got washed away in the 64 flood. The little town moved inland a little bit further away from the mouth of the river. In addition to a store and things, there is a casino and a hotel. That is the town of Klamath.
That's the only big building.
Then we travel through more redwoods as we approach the town of Crescent City.
We can plug it in now.
Now we are approaching Crescent City. There's a lot of things by the water, places to stay. You go through town and eventually you'll get on a freeway, which is on 101, and then you take the first exit that goes to 199 to go to Jedediah Smith State Park. When we arrived at the park, we went to the day use area, and there's a pay station there, although we have a pass. There's a lot of nice picnic tables, and they have like life preservers people can use without extra charge if they're going to be swimming in the river. Please hit the subscribe button and hit like and leave your comments below. Oh. Then we walked upriver a little bit to see what more of the park is like. We saw a little rapid here, and we waited and watched a bit. Then we saw some kayakers arriving, so we thought that we would watch them going through the rapids. Now watch carefully as this woman goes through the rapids. You'll learn some things to do and some things not to do. She has a nice bounce, and she goes sideways, and the wave hits her and knocks her out. She let go of her kayak, and she also let go of her paddle. I've fallen over and let go of my paddle, but I've always held onto my boat or kayak. And you don't want to be there without a paddle or your kayak. Fortunately, she is with other people that can help her. That's why often when people go to the river, they go in a group. If someone needs help, others can help them. And the other thing is, if you're all new to that, you want to go to a place where there's a big, gentle, level thing after the rapids so you have time to regroup and get your act together.
level 5.
Then we took the river trail for a little while to see other places along the river and eventually get to the campsites. Periodic flooding can bring new soil and life to the river's plants.
Wow, this is really a perfect spot.
We went down to the river again, and this beach area is where people in the campgrounds and campsites come down to use the river. Not that there's other places too. A campsite by the river. After we left the park and went towards the South Fork of the river, we could see a lot of people down there in very popular places. We didn't walk down. We looked for other easier access places where there'd be a lot less people. Another spot we found looked pretty nice, but it was pretty steep to get down, so we kept going till we found an easier place. We kept going up the South Fork Road till we saw a sign, River Access Sand Camp. There is like pit toilets there, and they tell you not to camp overnight in the parking area, but people do camp down by the river. Nobody was camping by the river when we were there. There were a few other people by the river, but not very many, so it seemed like a pretty private place to be. Then we went a little bit further upriver. We saw some nice scenic spots, but no easy places to access the water. Thank you for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this video.